has witnessed vindictive attacks depicting the beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
The more you attack him, is the more we love him. The more you attack him, is the more we follow him. The more you attack him, is the more we imitate him sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
In a time where Muslims have sold their morals.
There's people with riba coming to the masjids and donating. There's no one to question them. There should be a clear sign in my way, if I had a masjid, there should be a clear sign, don't bring your filth here. You want to give pure money, give it to the masjid. You know, the brothers, you know, if I win the lottery, man, can I build a masjid? My God, you win a lottery, you want to build a masjid, fine. But that masjid will only take me your hellfire.
In a time that our brothers and sisters are being brutally attacked.
Your brothers and sisters, your women, are being raped and murdered. Your children are being blown to bits. And you don't do anything? Or worse, you work with the enemy?
In a time when the masses feel a void in their life.
This void is where the vast majority of humanity fell. This is the void which says, I want to know Allah. I want to be close to Allah, man. I don't want to be doing that sin. And that's the void which you and I may have overlooked, and that is the secret why the thirst never quenches, ya ikhwan.
There still exists hope. Al-Hikmah presents Islamic Summit 2012, featuring Sheikh Shadi Al-Sulaiman from Australia.
And when the Muslim Ummah turns back to the path of Islam, then this Muslim Ummah will see the victory and the dignity and the respect that Allah Azza wa Jal had given it in the past.
Sheikh Hassan Ali from England.
You know, there's hikmah, there's ways of you got to look at each person differently and see how you're going to call the deen. You can't just say, haram, hairstyle haram, jeans haram, this haram, that haram, you haram. Whichever, you can't do that. Brothers come to the deen, you know, he wants. You can't just say, you know, don't listen, don't do this, don't do that. You give that much, right? The guy's just going to turn away from the deen. You've got to take it easy. On some people, you've got to take it easy.
Imam Ali Hamouda from Wales.
Is it the one who eats and drinks from the most exquisite and luxurious types of food and drink until he cannot breathe? Or is it the one who spends a day fasting in Ramadan or a Monday or Thursday to then experience the peace and tranquility and the taste of the date and the water when he sees the sun setting to experience another joy, knowing he's just invested in his hereafter and his relationship with Allah? Which of the two are happier? Which of the two are happier, ikhwan? Is it the one who's looking to make money from any avenue of haram, whether by drugs or by alcohol, whether by clubbing, whatever it may be, whether by doing people over, and then holding this money tightly, it's gonna leave me. I can't give out. I need this money. Is this person happy? Or is it the one who makes a halal and pure earning, even if it's a little bit less, to experience that joy of nafaqah, of sadaqah, of giving out, to experience the sensation of hearing that orphan whom you've sponsored from your halal earnings saying to you, Jazakallahu khayran.
Also featuring an exclusive Q&A session with Ken O'Keefe, a former US Marine who became a human shield to protect Iraqi civilians during the American invasion of Iraq.
I am a Palestinian. My heart and my soul is with Palestine, and it matters not where my blood comes from.